All right, breaking inputs coming in. Remember, neighborhood first policy. That's what is going to be witnessed today during the oath-taking ceremony with the presence of foreign dignitaries from the neighboring countries of India. Maldives President Mohamed Muizu has arrived to take part in the oath-taking ceremony. You also have the Prime Minister of Mauritius, Kumar Jagnauth, was also arrived and was received by the ambassadors. Pragya is joining us with more details. What we have right now, the visuals of the Maldives president, Mr. Muizu, being received, he being welcomed in the national capital. Very interesting because this is happening amid strained ties between both the countries, with Maldives now, of course, making an all-out effort to normalize the ties between India and Maldives.
Well, absolutely. It's a, they have been invited because of the neighborhood policy. Prime Minister has always focused that we should have a cordial relation with the neighbors, irrespective what their bent of mind is. But there had been a controversy in the past regarding Lakshadweep when Prime Minister visited it. And because Maldives is, you know, the whole economy is based on tourism, there was a lot of diplomatic action that were taken against India. India also took those action against Maldives. But it looks like that now Maldives is trying to reaching out to India. Obviously, it's a welcome gesture that Prime Minister has invited them for the oath-taking ceremony. Not just that, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Seychelles, they all have been invited for Prime Minister Narendra Modi's oath-taking ceremony. In 2014, it was SAARC nations. In 2019, it was BIMSTEC nations. Now, the neighborhood policy seems to be taking over when it comes to the foreign policy and when it comes to the diplomatic relation and how to enhance and show that we want you to be on the cordial relations. We are reaching out to you, and Maldives also reached out by agreeing to come to this oath-taking ceremony. Obviously, this is an opportunity that India has taken to ensure that it will reach out to every neighbor. Important these are, be it Nepal, be it Bhutan, be it Bangladesh. And Prime Minister has time and again also shown to these leaders how magnanimous India is in helping the neighbors. And they also recognize the fact that India has got a stature among the world leaders as well. So in that sense, it becomes very important. Foreign dignitaries and the head of states have been part of the oath-taking ceremony in the past as well. Especially, there is a strategy when it comes to oath-taking of Prime Minister designate Mr. Narendra Modi. And this time as well, Ms. Sheikh Hasina has already reached. And now we are hearing that Mr. Muizu has already reached India as well to take participate right. in this.
It's going to be a grand event. Accommodation for 7,000 to 8,000 guests have been booked, and security measures also beefed up. Sabyasachi and Mohit Bhatt also are on the broadcast with us. Let me quickly first go across. Sabyasachi is reporting from outside the Prime Minister's residence at the moment as well. Sabyasachi, we're given to understand that there are other meetings happening. One that we just reported happening between JP Nadda and Amit Shah. And the cabinet mantris, individuals who are going to be inducted and retained, getting calls at around 11, I believe. We'll get to see who all have been called up and confirm that they are a part of Cabinet 3.0.
Well, absolutely. One meeting is taking place at Union Home Minister Amit Shah's residence between Amit Shah and JP Nadda. See, last night, as per the sources, the JDU also had called in a meeting to discuss their own agendas. See, at around 11 a.m., the leaders would start coming in. See, as of now, the BJP leaders are getting called. Some of them are being retained, but the question is whether they would also retain the ministry that they were holding in the previous term or not. That remains to be seen. That will be clear once the oath ceremony is over. And after that, the relocation of the portfolios would be done. See, at this particular time, a lot have changed since 2019. See, BJP this time around has got around 240, and it relies a lot on its ally partners. So the ally partners equation would be extremely important, because though Nitish Kumar and Chandrababu Naidu and other leaders, Chirag Paswan and Jayant Chaudhary, though all of them have said that they don't have anything on their agenda, they have given unconditional support. But as per the sources, as we know, that back channel talks have been going on. They have prepared their own set of demands. They have asked for a special package for the state of Bihar, for the state of Andhra Pradesh as well. So all these demands need to be addressed. But first and foremost, it is very much important that Prime Minister Narendra Modi takes the oath for the third time, meets all the leaders who's going to come to his residence and sends out a message.
Sabyasachi, stay on with us. We're getting some breaking inputs about how Karnataka is also hoping for a bigger share when it comes to the cabinet. And according to the breaking inputs that we're getting, Mr. Basavaraj Bommai has also...